Thank you, Mr. Nadler. Before I begin, let me remind you, Mr. Lewandowski, that this is not a Republican primary campaign. You are not on the campaign trail yet. This is the House Judiciary Committee. Act like you know the difference. You've never worked for the Trump White House in any official capacity, correct?
That's right.
But you do speak with President Trump with some regularity, true?
I think it's a fair statement.
In fact, during the summer of 2017, according to testimony to the special counsel, you were summoned to the White House by President Trump on at least two occasions, correct?
I don't believe the report says that, Congressman.
Okay, well, you met with the president one-on-one on June 19th, 2017, and then again on July 19th, 2017, correct?
Yes, I believe that's accurate.
Okay, let's try to get some clarity on what exactly you do for Donald Trump since you're not a government employee. You stated during the 2016 Republican National Convention that I got the reputation as a tough guy. That's my reputation. Do you recall making that statement, Mr. Lewandowski?
I don't.
Okay. It's in the public record. Your job is to be Donald Trump's political enforcer, correct?
No, I don't believe so.
Let me ask the question another way. Are you the hitman, the bag man, the lookout, or all of the above?
I think I'm the good-looking man, actually.
Okay. President Trump told you on June 19, 2017, to personally deliver a message to Attorney General Sessions that would have ended the criminal investigation into the Trump campaign, correct?
I don't believe that's what the Mueller report states, no.
President Trump wanted Attorney General Sessions to limit the special counsel's investigation to future incidents of election foreign interference, true?
Which page is that on, Congressman?
That's in the public record. It's in this hearing. It's in the Mueller report. Now, the White House has a legal protocol for presidential statements. Under the Presidential Records Act, they must preserve all memos, letters, emails, papers, like the note he dictated to you. So you wrote down the president's message, which you then stored in a safe in your home. Is that correct?
Yes, it is.
Okay. You told the special counsel that was your standard procedure with sensitive items, correct?
Where is that reference in the report to you, sensitive items?
Volume 2, page 92, a matter of
public record. Just reference that. 1 second, Congressman.
You don't have to reference it. The president asked you to...
You say page 90, Congressman?
The president asked you to... reclaiming my time. The president asked you to record a message from him on June 19th because he wanted to hide his message from eventual disclosure. Isn't that right?
No.
Okay. But you never delivered the message to Jeff Sessions after that June 19th meeting, true?
That's accurate.
Instead, you testified that you went on vacation, correct?
I did.
How long was your vacation, Mr. Lewandowski?
Oh, it was lengthy. I think at least 2 weeks.
At least 2 weeks. But you were summoned again to the White House on July 19th, 30 days after the original June 19th meeting, true?
I believe that's accurate, yes.
So you weren't on vacation the entire time, correct?
Oh, I didn't say I was on vacation the entire time. I was on vacation for 2 weeks, Congressman.
Right, but you still failed to deliver the message, and it had nothing to do, at least in part, to your so-called vacation. Now, the July 19th meeting occurred just a few days after new information came to light about Russian operatives meeting with high-level Trump campaign officials. When you're summoned to the White House after that July 19th meeting, by that time, you still hadn't delivered the message to Jeff Sessions. You said to the president you would do it soon, according to Volume 2, page 93, correct?
If that's what the report says, that's accurate.
Okay. President Trump also asked you to deliver a message to Attorney General Sessions that if he didn't do what was requested, he would be fired, correct? Volume 2, page 93.
I think that's what was reported, yes.
Okay. President Trump wanted you to intimidate Attorney General Sessions, correct?
Well, you'd have to ask President Trump that.
Okay. Now, you stated earlier today that President Trump asked you to take down dictation, quote, many times. Is that correct?
It is.
But on page 91, volume 2 of the Mueller report, it states, quote, the president then asked Lewandowski to deliver a message to Sessions and said, quote, write this down, close quote. This was the first time the president had asked Lewandowski to take direct dictation. The first time.
Those are not my words, Congressman. Those are the investigator's words.
Right. Did you lie to Bob Mueller, or are you lying to us?
I didn't lie.
Okay. You're not really here to tell the truth. You are here to participate in a continuing cover-up. Russia interfered with this election in sweeping and systematic fashion. The Trump campaign welcomed that assistance at the highest level. There were subsequent acts of obstruction of justice with respect to the investigation. Chairman. The American people deserve to Chairman. Know the truth.
Mr. Chairman,
the gentleman yields back. The gentleman.
I think I was 19 seconds.